Hi, I'm Somanimus. Today we're going to learn how to set up a door system in order to navigate between two scenes in 5 minutes. Let's go. Let's create our door scene. It will be an area 2D. We'll name it door. Then we add a collision shape 2D. In its shape field, we set a rectangle shape. We also need a marker 2D, which will be our spawn location. We add a script to handle the door navigation. We define the class name door, then we want the destination scene tag, the destination door tag, as we can have many doors in the same scene, the spawn direction for the current scene door, and a reference to the spawn marker. Let's connect the area to our script by going to Node tab, click Body Entered, then select our script to generate a new function on Body Entered. The body can be anybody, so let's make sure you define a class name for your player. Now you can ensure that the rest of the script is executed only if the body that enters is of type player. Now let's put some doors in our scene. We add a node to contain our doors. Inside of it, we instantiate a scene of type door. Then we set its position using the move tool. Name it with a meaningful suffix. I'll go with W for west. Let's move our spawn position. For this, right-click the door, then check editable children. Then drag the spawn a bit further. Click back on the door to set our destination level, level 1. In our level 1, we want to spawn to the eastern door here. So we put E as destination, and for the spawn direction, right, as we want to arrive like this. Let's quickly set up the second door. The destination scene is lobby, the door W, and the spawn direction left. We need a global script to store the door information. Let's call it Navigation Manager. Then we open it. And we want to preload the different scenes. We've got one scene for the lobby, which we can drag and drop from our file system, and another scene for level 1. We also need the destination tag. Then we can create the main method to go to a level at a specific door tag. First, let's figure out which scene to load. We use match to check the value of our level tag. And depending on its value, we provide the corresponding scene to load. If the scene has been set, we store the spawn door tag. Then we load the scene using getTree change scene to packed with our scene as parameter. Now let's make our navigation script global. For this, go to Project, Auto Load, find our script in the Explorer, and click Add. Now you can use the Navigation Manager in your scripts and call the GoToLevel method with our door attributes. We can now test. We do go to the other level, but not to the door position yet. So in our level script, we want to check if Navigation Manager has a spawn door tag. If so, let's call a new function to manage fetching the door and telling the player where to spawn. In the function, we fetch the door corresponding to the tag by giving the path of doors and appending our door tag. Then we get the right nodes thanks to the getNodes method. And we can now access the door attributes, the spawn position and spawn direction. Now in Navigation Manager, we create a signal which will tell the player to spawn at the given position and direction. Create a function to trigger our signal with both attributes, position, a vector 2, and direction, a string. In this function, we emit our signal with both attributes. Then we can call a new function from our level on spawn, providing the door spawn position and the door spawn direction. In the player script, in the ready function, we want to connect the Navigation Manager signal to a new function on spawn. We declare the function with the same parameters as our event in Navigation Manager, the position and the direction. We set the player global position to the position returned by Navigation Manager. For direction, it depends on how you animate your player. For me, it's animation move underscore direction. You'll have to adapt this code to fit your situation. Here you go! The player can now navigate between our two scenes back and forth. If you'd like to add a fade effect, go watch the next video linked in the description. If this tutorial was useful to you, click the like button and subscribe to see more short tutorials like this one. See you soon!